अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू लेक्चर 3। इन दिस लेक्चर द लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन इज़ यूज्ड, सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू क्लियर द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ लॉ ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन। इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल डिटरमिन द मास ऑफ अर्थ। आई विल डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन 5.11 फ्रॉम द एक्सरसाइज एंड विल सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम 5.2। We have to determine the mass of the earth. To find the mass of earth, we will use the law of gravitation. Let's discuss this diagram. Consider we have the two objects. One object is earth and the other object is a small object which is placed on the surface of earth. Consider the mass of the small object is m and mass of the earth is capital M E. And the radius of the earth is r. Since the object is placed on the surface of earth and it is very small object, so the distance from the center of earth to the center of the object will be equal to the radius of the earth. Now according to law of gravitation, earth and small object attract each other with the force. This force is called force of gravitation. Consider this force is F. So law of gravitation will become F is equal to capital G M M E upon R square. Here M1 is M, M2 is M E, and D is R. Give this equation number 1. As we know that earth attracts every other object towards its center, which is the force of gravitation. This force of gravitation always equal to the weight of the object. Here force of gravitation equal to weight and weight is equal to mg. Give this equation number 2. As it is the force of gravitation and it is also the force of gravitation in equation number 1, these are attracting with the same force, therefore we will compare this equation number 1 with equation number 2, then we will get mg is equal to capital G m m e upon r square. Now this m will cancel out with this m, so we will get g is equal to capital G m e upon r square. This is the formula which is used to find the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of earth. But we have to find the mass of the earth, so we will isolate this m e. So we will get m e is equal to r square multiplied by small g upon capital G. It is the formula which is used to find the mass of the earth, and this formula is also used to find the mass of any object. If you want to find the mass of any object, then you need the radius of that object, acceleration due to gravity on that object, and value of the universal constant, which is 6.673 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 11 newton meter square per kilogram square. But here we have to find the mass of the earth, so we need radius of the earth, which is equal to 6.4 multiplied by 10 raised to power 6 meter, and acceleration due to gravity on the surface of earth, which is 10 ms minus 2. Value of the g will remain same, which is 6.673 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 11 newton meter square per kilogram square. Now we will substitute these values in this equation, then we will get ME is equal to 6.4 multiplied by 10 raised to power 6 meter whole square multiplied by 10 ms minus 2 whole divided by 6.673 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 11 newton meter square per kilogram square. After simplification of this step, you will get the mass of the earth, which is 5.2 9736 multiplied by 10 raised to power 24 kilogram, which is approximate equal to 6 multiplied by 10 raised to power 24 kilogram, and it is the value of the mass of the earth. Conceptual question: can we determine the mass of our moon? If yes, what you need to know? Do it yourself. This is the formula which is used to find the mass of the moon. This mm, mass of the moon. This is rm, which is the radius of the moon. This is gm, which is acceleration due to gravity on the moon, and it is universal constant of gravitation. Problem 5.2. The gravitational force between two identical lead spheres kept at 1 meter apart is 0.006673 newton. Find their masses. We will take the given data from this statement. F is equal to 0.006673 newton. D is equal to 1 meter. We have to find the two masses of lead spheres. Since the masses are identical, so M1 is equal to M2 is equal to M. We will use the law of gravitation. Here M1 is equal to M and M2 is equal to M. M multiplied by M, M square. We have to find the mass, so we will isolate this M square. M square will be equal to F multiplied by D square upon capital G. Now we will substitute the values from this given data in this equation. After simplification, we will get 10 raised to power 4 kilogram, which is equal to 10,000 kilogram each. Since the two identical lead spheres, therefore mass of each lead sphere is 10,000 kilogram.